started.
I've learned something about Islam and how to live in Islam. I know that there are many, many parts of Islam. And what's the main thing in your religion that you believe?
Good. The first thing, the main thing in Islam is submit our will to the will of God. That's the main thing in Islam. To anyone who submit his will or her will to the will of God, then they are Muslims. So that's why Jesus was a Muslim, because he said, let it be not my will, but your will. So he submit his will to the will of God. Moses, the same thing. Abraham, all prophets of God, they submit their will to the will of God. That's why they are Muslims. So anyone who submit his will to the will of God is a Muslim. So that's the main thing. The other thing, which is the second thing in Islam, as well, we believe that Allah, as well, Allah, by the way, in Arabic means the one God. As well, Allah has angels, has created angels. Those they have no, they have no decision that they take from themselves. But actually, that meaning that they just follow.
No free will.
They have no free will. Yeah. So those angels. And God has sent those angels to convey the message, that one of them, like Gabriel, sent him to the prophets of God to convey his message to the people. So that's another thing. Now, as well, we believe that God has sent revelations to the people. Because if God created us, why he created us? What's the purpose of our life? What we are doing here on this earth? Is it just only eating and drinking and reproduction? Animals do a better job than this. We have a purpose. We are here to serve. This what God wants from us is to submit our will to him. And lastly, we to follow the guidance of the messengers of God. We believe that God has sent messengers one after another. All of them, he came to convey the message of God to the people. So some people, they believed in them, and some people went astray until the final and the last prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. He is the last prophet of God, and he came with the message, and he came with the miracle that he has, which is the Quran. And if you allow me, I will talk to you about the miracles of the Quran, if you want to hear about it. Now, Quran reached or came conveyed to Muhammad, or was revealed to Muhammad, peace be upon him, 1400 years ago. And the language of the Quran, even amongst people, many German people, by the way, they studied Arabic language and they studied the Quran, and they found the Quran, the language of the Quran, so amazing, made some of them accept Islam. But now, what's your name, by the way? Your name?
What's Sigrid.
Sigrid. And your name?
Johanna.
So Sigrid and Johanna. So how Sigrid and Johanna will appreciate the Quran, will understand the Quran, but they can't speak Arabic. But the Quran has miracles. And those miracles, which has made people to accept Islam, which they are called scientific miracles of the Quran. Meaning, we're not talking about, and those are scientific facts. Facts mentioned in the Quran, 1400 years ago, that Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, have no access to the science and has no access to the knowledge until we discovered it recently. So when we look into it and when we say, how did Muhammad 1400, peace be upon him, how did he found out about this? And he claims this information didn't come from me. It came from the creator of the heavens and earth. And for example, I'll give you some example if you wanted to hear. Yeah.
Do you want
to say something? Okay. Yeah, say it. Speaker's corner. Sorry, I'm very passionate about it.
Yeah, and I think you should tell to others as well.
Yes.
Only one question. Do you think that men and women are totally equal in front of God?
Yeah, that's true. They are totally equal in front of God. That's
you
true.
You respect your wife as she respects you, and she's got the same rights.
Yes, but they have different tasks.
Different roles.
Yeah.
In the life. So that's why the Prophet ﷺ, he said in very clear hadith, he said, إِنَّمَا النِّسَاءُ شِقَاقُ الرِّجَالِ. Really, the women, they are like the men in terms of certain things. So they have certain roles to play, and men have certain roles to play. So, and that's why we, unfortunately, recently, we can't, because we confuse things, we mix things. That's why no one knows what is the role of the man, no one knows what's the role of the woman. And that's why that we live in a confused society. Well, in fact, the role of, for example, of the husband is to take care of his wife and to look after her financially and to make sure that she's safe, she's protected, and all of these things, that's the role of the husband. And as well, the role of the wife as well, to take care of her husband as well, to look after him, and as well, and both of them, they have to participate in bringing up the children. This is what Islam is teaching us. And actually, Islam as well favored the mother more than the father. As our Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he said, that who, when a companion came and asked him, he said, who is the best person I should be close to? He said, your mother. He said, then who? He said, then your mother. He said, then who? He said, then your mother. He said, then who? He said, then your father. So the right of the mother in Islam, three times over than the right of the father in Islam. So this is the beauty of Islam.
Thank you very much for all your information.
Okay, do you want to have a free copy of the Quran? By the way, can you get us, brothers, just some two copies of the Quran from there? Just have it, have a read about it. You got one? Okay, you read something of the Quran. So, okay, in German?
Yes.
Okay, what did you learn from it?
I learned that God has 101,000 names or something.
No, 99 names, here.
Thank you.
All right, all right. Anyway, all right, thank you, thank you, thank you so much. JazakAllah. It was good, you know, even though.
Yeah, yeah.
The people, they feel overwhelmed when they are at, you know, with the camera, surrounding the camera.
This man alive in here to stop the recording. Mad.